This month's free example puppet is Barbara Soros. She is a clay sculpted stop motion style dinosaur newscaster. And she's got a lot of really cool features to her. So not only does she have this nice clay, physical, tangible sculpted style, she's got a great control panel down here so you can turn on little, you know, things. Vegetarian, should we be eating them? And then you can change what that is with this slider here. And you can actually add your own custom ones in the appropriate file that's linked here. You also can add these little breaking news things, triggers that show up at the bottom. And these are just replays that are added in and triggered as you press things. And then the desk can actually go away as well. You've got a few different backgrounds here you can pick from, again, using the slider to decide between them. You can change the character X position. And you'll see her hair get some dangle in the necklace around her as well. So there's some nice physics there. And then she's also got a tail that wags. She can blink too. She can also interact with some of the objects on her desk. So if I press M, she puts the coffee cup in her hand. If I press N, she has the papers. And if I press 1, she'll kind of shuffle those papers on her desk, take that away. And then P will put the pencil in her hand. And the nice thing about these is they'll all work with her arm animations. So actually if you press the 1 through 5 keys, and so 2 does on the desk, 3 does up like that, 4 does down, and 5 does out like that. And so if you added in like the cup and the pencil and press these, they will actually move with the arms. So they're actually attached to them. So Barbara Soros was made by David Taub, and he has created several character animator puppets in this style before, including Dr. Applesmith, who's part of the start workspace when you first load up character animator. But I asked David, if other people are interested in this, how would they go about creating their own, you know, clay sculpted character? And he put together a little video for us. So check it out.
Hi, I'm David Taub, and I created the Barbara Soros puppet for Adobe Character Animator. I want to talk a little bit about my process for creating a puppet out of a clay sculpture. My one disclaimer is that I've made up this process. I've just tried whatever works for me and discovered what things I want to keep on doing. So do that, figure out what works for you, but this is what works for me. I like to use Sculpey modeling clay, which comes in all sorts of different colors. And if I can't find the exact color that I want, I can mix two different colors. For instance, the green that I used for Barbara Soros was a mix of a straight up green, and then I smushed some yellows and browns in there and kept on rolling and smushing and pulling and smushing some more until it all became one nice cohesive color. Sculpey can also be hardened by baking it in the oven, which is useful for me. I bake most of the parts after I've sculpted it and gotten it exactly the way I want it to look, and then I'll bake it so that it doesn't change or deform or get smushed or ruined in any other way when I photograph it. There are some parts though, for this puppet it's the mouths, that I don't bake, and I've left them soft. There's two reasons for that. The first reason being that when it's soft, it's tacky. So for the mouths, I want to switch them around and I can just stick it on. And so that would be harder if the part was baked already and then I'd have to stick it on with something else. The second reason is because you'll notice I haven't made all of the mouths. There's only about 9 here. Some of them are missing. And the reason for that is because they are soft, I can put this on and then for like eh and ah, I can just open that up more to make a different viseme. So I didn't have to sculpt all of them. I also did not sculpt all of the legs. You'll see here, I only sculpted one leg. I took pictures of this one leg and I used that for both the legs and the arms in the final puppet. I also want to talk about which parts I decide to sculpt all in one piece and which parts are sculpted separately. So you'll see here, for instance, the hair comes off. The leg is not attached to the body. And it all depends on how the puppet works and what I want it to do. So for example, this hair, I wanted it to be able to have a little bit of a dangle, a little bit of a bob and move around separately. So I wanted to be able to photograph it separately and have the head photographed separately so I could put that back on in Photoshop and let it move around. So I sculpted them separately. Obviously the mouths I needed to swap out, so I needed to do those separately as well. For this, I wanted to make custom backgrounds just for Barbara Soros. I thought about sculpting them out of clay as well, but ultimately I decided to use paper cutouts to give it a still has a three-dimensional look, but it has a slightly different texture, which I felt would be a nice combination and shake things up a little bit. So you'll see I painted these backgrounds with watercolor on cardstock, and then I cut them out. This little desk, I drew that on paper and then cut out the pieces and folded it. And then I took pictures of each of those parts separately. So that's it. That's everything I wanted to talk about. Enjoy the Barbasaurus puppet, and I'm really excited to see what everybody does with her.
All right, that was great. Thank you so much, David, for the puppet and for the explanation and look behind the scenes of your process. If you make anything with Barbasaurus or anything with the clay style of characters, we would love to see it. So please share it on social media with hashtag character animator. And if you're running into any trouble, either with the creation process or rigging or recording or editing or anything with character animator, the best place for help is the official Adobe Character Animator forums. That's it for this month. Thank you very much for watching, and have fun.